when you mess with your equipment, there's some risk that you may change your luck. So with that being said, we're going to see if we can't take the little slack out of this handle, which is not very much on the joystick, but it needs to be done, or at least make some effort to try to get it where it's... And take this little linkage off right here. None of these are very tight. And there's a little bushing that mounts on top of this thing, so make sure you put that bushing back in place when you get ready to put it back together. So now we see this is totally free. Pull these three little nuts off right here. See if we can't get down in there. Notice that none of this stuff is really very tight. It's just it's tight enough that it won't come apart. I'd say 15 inch pounds. I mean inches of torque on it. 15 inches of torque, perhaps, if it's that much. Okay, this plate lifts off, and we have the snap ring, which we're going to unsnap. And we're unsnapped. Here, you can see that the shaft is not quite square with this, and it has a bushing in it. So I'm sure that's a delrin bushing. And the bushing split right there. Okay, these are stops, and this is the adjustment pin right here that tightens this collet down around the bushing. Well, I guess the thing to do is to just reach down here with this hook thing, give it a little friendly tug, and that brings it out. And this is the bearing, and it goes over that collet just like that. Rod. None of this is particularly polished well. What I'm working on right now is to try to open up that split just a little bit so that it's got more room to pinch down on this. Okay, the object of this exercise at this point is we're going to try to open this gap up a little bit more with the hacksaw blade. And then which requires holding the bushing, and then just gently sawing. Clean this up a little bit with that X-Acto knife, which is really sharp, so you gotta be extra careful with that thing. Now in reassembly, where this gap is here, we want to have it exactly 180 degrees, or roughly 180 degrees. From this slot here, so that it's clamping on the back side of it, and it'll pull this gap down and increase the tension of this bushing around this pole. Now this, the internals of this has machine marks in it, and I don't know the depth of those machine marks, are not very deep, but it does reduce down its ability to maintain tension. So, but I don't think that's part of the slack problem. Now, when we've done here, you can see that we're roughly maybe 3/32 in expanded width of this bushing. And this bushing is what clamps against the pipe. This clamps around the bushing. All right, so I've cut a bigger slot, big slot. It fits rather loosely on here now. But when we clamp it down, it will be able to take up the slack instead of butting up against itself. Here it is inserted in there. There's the slot for the bushing. Here's the slot for the coupling. We'll slide that down on there. And that feels pretty good. So now we'll put this snap ring back on there. Now we're snapped on. Give it a little lift there to see if it works. Works fine. All right, got them snug. Now we'll just give them a little bump here to get them down to torque. And the next adjustment's then clamping it down to see if it took the slack out of it, which is anybody's guess. Middle one's the one that tightens it. What I just did was flip this thing up because it loosened the bolt on this thing. That stud wasn't in there particularly tight. Well, that took the slack out of it. Set those set screws down where they're finger tight. All right, snug this up. Okay, that fixed it. All righty, look at that, fixed, finally. I think my approach would be different the next time. When instead of trying to hold this stuff by hand, I'd probably put it in the vise and use the Dremel tool to spread that out a bit. I mean, you clamp it down and then you use the Dremel tool to remove probably 3/32, maybe 1/16 of an inch off of that delrin bushing in there, and then clean it up with an X-Acto knife to make sure that you got all the drill filings out of the way and machine filings and then reassemble it. Now, one of the things that I didn't do when I flipped this thing upside down, when I first put this on here, that post that this bears on, it was loose. And it has a 4.5 millimeter hex head screw down there, and it needs to be tightened up. And I would suggest, if you're going to go to this effort, to pull that post out of there, treat it with blue Loctite, and then reinstall it, the bolt down there at the bottom of it. I haven't put Loctite on any of this thing other than on the front rest mechanism, because it keeps trying to sit sideways. But anyway, that concludes the video, and it did take the slack out of the handle. Works just like it should. So with that, have a good day. Enjoy your rest. Thank you.